I love you so much.
Hey, Jack. Can't you hear me, Jackoff? You deaf, Jackoff? Can't fucking speak either?
Say something!
Hey! What's going on here?
Nothing, Miss Taylor.
Nothing? Doesn't look like nothing. You boys get back to class. Now! Back to class! Jack, you okay?
I think it's dead.
Which one? That guy? No. Poor thing. He's just scared. See? Somebody there? Jack?
Did I scare you, Miss Taylor?
No, it's locked.
Shouldn't you be home? My mom's picking me up.
Okay, well, I better run.
Where are you going?
To a funeral. My old piano teacher.
Can I come?
No, Jack. A funeral's a very, very private affair.
I've never been to a funeral before.
It wouldn't be appropriate. Anyway, wouldn't your mother worry?
Not really.
I'm sure she would.
Have a wonderful day, okay? I'll see you in class tomorrow.
Okay. Bye.
We have entrusted our brother James Hutton to God's mercy in sure and certain hope of the resurrection.
white roses. They were his favorite. How did you know?
They just seemed appropriate somehow.
Mrs. Hutton, I'm so sorry.
Thank you, Anna. You look tired, dear.
No, I'm fine. Everything's fine.
I'm so sorry.
Scared the life out of me.
No, I'm sorry.
Oh, your hair.
Do you not like it?
No, I didn't say that. It's just very, very red. Not really you, is it?
Are you ready to order?
Yes, we'll have the duck, please.
Paul.
I always have the duck here.
I don't always have the duck.
Very good. Listen, let's try not to fight tonight, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
What are we drinking?
Oh, yes, all right.
It's good. And it has a very expensive-looking label. What's the special occasion?
Well, there's something I really need to talk to you about. About us. I've been offered a transfer to head office in Chicago. It's going to mean a lot more work, of course, a lot of responsibility and a lot of changes, but it's an incredible opportunity, and I'd be crazy to turn it down. So I'm thinking maybe it's time for us to...
You're leaving me.
What?
I mean, you could have told me this morning. You didn't have to buy me off with this expensive dinner.
Yeah, wait.
No. I mean, you told me everything was going to be okay.
Don't be ridiculous, Anna. You've got it all wrong.
I'm not being ridiculous.
Jesus Christ, can we get through one meal without arguing, please?
No.
Just
no.
One meal.
Apparently we can't. Apparently I'm not capable of that.
Maybe you are. I'm beginning to wonder.
Fuck you.
Please, everyone's watching. Don't do this.
Fuck you.
Okay, you're crazy. You're just like your goddamn mother.
I am nothing like my mother.
You know, I'm not running after you, Anna.
Good.
Anna, come on. Please open the door.
Don't wait here.
Listen, I want you to come.
Don't do this. Anna. Hey. Anna, I want you to come to Chicago. Anna. God damn it.
Please, no.
Shit.
You asshole.
You're in a funeral home. You're dead. You were in a car accident.
Shit!
You hit a truck loaded with metal pipes.
I'm not dead.
You were pronounced dead 8 hours ago. Your blood no longer circulates through your body. Your brain cells are slowly dying. Your body's already decomposing.
I'm not dead.
This is your death certificate.
Cause of death,
massive internal trauma. Time of death, 8:23 p.m. You were dead on arrival. The attendant physician signed here at 9:45 last night. I'm sorry.
What's happening? Why can't I move? Don't touch me. Why are you touching me?
I'm preparing your body. You have to look beautiful for your funeral.
I'm not dead.
You all say the same thing. Maybe you should rest now.
Baby, you got it wrong. I want you to come to Chicago. I want you to come. Okay, we gotta talk. I'm gonna come by your place before I go to the office. And everything's gonna be fine. I promise. Call me when you get this. I love you so much. Okay, I'll see you soon.
Michelle Gross.
Hi, I'm looking for Anna Taylor.
I'm sorry, you can't just come in.
I'm Anna's fiance, Paul Coleman. This is her room, right?
She didn't come in today.
What is she? Is she calling sick?
She didn't call in at all.
Okay, yeah, thanks. Sorry, thank you.
She's a school teacher. I know, it's always so difficult when they're so young. That's right, you knew her. She was at your funeral. She's in good hands now.
Where's Anna?
Anna was in a car accident last night. My daughter's dead. That's what's happened.
Car accident? When? What are you
know.
They said it happened just before 8:30.
We were at a restaurant.
You shouldn't have let her drive in that weather.
She can't be dead. There must be some mistake.
There's no mistake. And flowers. How appropriate.
Why wouldn't you call me?
You took her away from me. I don't want you anywhere near her.
Please don't hurt me.
How could I hurt you? You're already dead.
I can't be dead.
Then why are you here?
Just let me go. Please, please. I won't tell anyone, I promise.
You're still in denial. You have to trust me. I'm only here to help you.
What's happening? Why can't I feel anything? Why are you keeping me here?
Setting in so I can work on your body. Your mother's early. I'm so very sorry, Mrs. Taylor. It's always so tragic when one loses a child. If you'd care to come to my office, we can make arrangements.
I want to see her.
But she hasn't been prepared.
I don't care. I want to see her.
Of course. This way.
Oh,
forgive me. As I said, I've only just started preparing her. So sorry.
The point of preserving the body if the soul has already left?
No, the soul is still here.
It's we who suffer. We are left behind. Who's going to take care of me now? Did you think about that?
I'll confirm the date with Father Graham this afternoon. Friday is your request.
Do what you think is best. It's just details. Oh, there is one thing.
Yes.
Her hair. She was a brunette. I'd like it back to that color.
Of course.
Mom, you were supposed to pick me up from school yesterday.
Okay, but don't touch anything with your hands, just find those two Easter eggs. Are you ready? And I'll take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have to find the two Easter eggs. You have 30 seconds. You understand the problem? And, of course, the usual catch is and beat the clock is you can't use your hands. You have to go after these with your teeth.
I must be in shock. I'm just in shock. It's okay.
Graham, thanks for calling back. Yes, I'd like to confirm the burial service for Friday. The deceased is Anna Taylor, T-A-Y-L-O-R. Yes, she's downstairs. May I help you?
Elliot Deacon?
Yes.
Paul Coleman?
Of course. The lawyer. It's a small town. In my line of work, you get to know everyone eventually.
I'm Anna Taylor's fiancée.
That's strange. She wasn't wearing an engagement ring.
We're not quite fiancée.
Mr. Coleman, I am so sorry for your loss.
I'd like to see her.
I'm afraid the viewing isn't until Thursday evening.
I need to see her right now, please. If that's possible.
I'm sorry. It's not possible. You're not family.
Please, give me 5 minutes.
I do understand, Mr. Cole.
You don't understand! You don't understand!
Paul! Paul! I'm down here!
Please. Please let me just see her.
There really is nothing I can do. I'm so sorry.
Who was that?
No one.
No one?
It was Paul.
I know. I heard you talking to him. Why wouldn't you let him see me?
Did you love him?
None of your business.
You weren't going to tell me he was here, were you?
No.
Why?
Because it would only hurt you. You have to let go of the living just as they have to let go of you.
I don't believe you. Why are you doing this to me?
You're all the same. You all blame me for your death as if it were my fault.
No, you drugged me. So my mother...
Others, they just see you as a dead body on the slab. Only I can see you as you really are.
You're a lunatic. You're crazy. You're completely crazy.
I don't have time for this. I'm a busy man. Oh, I nearly forgot. How tall are you?
Why?
I need to know your height for your coffin. Let's say 5'3" then.
Wait.
Coleman, I heard about your girlfriend. I'm sorry.
She's Tommen.
The captain just stepped out. He won't be long. You can wait in his office if you want.
Oh, no, thanks. I just gotta grab a drink.
You okay?
Yeah. No, I'm fine. I'm fine.
I just found out. I'm so sorry, man. Look, if there's anything you need at all...
I need to see Anne.
What do you mean?
The funeral director said I couldn't see her because I was in family. Can you please talk to him, Tom? Can you pull some strings or... Just show me a badge or something.
I can't do that, Paul.
I fucked up, man.
Are you sure you're okay?
Huh?
Yeah.
I always fuck everything up.
Thank you.
Who was she?
Mrs. Whitehall. Shouldn't be afraid of her. The dead can't harm the dead.
But I'm not
dead!
Stay where you are.
Give me the scissors. I only want to help you.
I'll kill you. I swear to God, I will kill you. I'm breathing. Maybe I was in some kind of coma and the doctors made a mistake.
You died, Anna. Everyone dies.
How can I be dead if I'm talking to you?
You're talking. Not because you're alive, but because I have a gift. I can talk to those between life and death. Help them make the transition.
So, am I a ghost? Is that why I'm here?
You're here so I can bury you. Come.
No, please, I don't want...
You're a corpse, Anna. Your opinion doesn't count anymore.
But I'm breathing. I must still be alive.
Oh, you people. You think because you breathe, piss, shit, you're alive? You clutch onto life as if your life was worth clutching onto. Was your life worth clutching onto, Anna? Was it? Maybe you died a long time ago. I'm surprised you're still arguing with me. You don't have much time left. Your funeral's in 2 days. Soon you're going to be enclosed in a coffin, then buried in the ground. No one can hear you then. No one can speak to you there.
Are you scared?
You're not ready. You're not ready.